5/6 of a second, but then the business gap is already opened up when they came into a 5/6 of the first time, and it's getting larger as I see them now going towards Shell Oil for the second time in the restarted race. The tail end Vipers making up for lost time after their spin on the first lap over at Cascade. And the leader at the moment, Paddy Shuffling, Didi Jeremy Metcalf, and they're all punching up behind. Morley Lamborghini in third place, still first in fourth. Fifth is still Guy Harrington. And then we've got the two Vipers up behind him. Still in the order of 2-1. Can Gornall do anything about Steve Clark ahead of him? He's right on the tail of the Viper, and Foster is right on the tail now of Guy Harrington.
And James Gornall looks on the inside. Yes!
Driving for you, and James is taking no prisoners of whatever. That's one Viper disposed of. He's got two more running side by side. I've got one Viper ahead of him running side by side. They go with the number, which one is it ahead of me? Number three, but the Ferrari of Guy Harrington is also a target. They were going side by side as they went into Island there. But James Gornall just slides through on the inside there of the Nick Foster Viper. They went into Cascades, and he is really on a charge. So James Gornall, remember, from the first grid, right at the very back he was. So the two leading Ferraris coming over hilltop into his lots, still headed by number 15. The gap's come down a little bit again by Paddy Shuffling, being caught once more by Jeremy Metcalf. Restarted race, and the 50 Paddy Shuffling coming under increasing pressure from what he was, but I don't think this time he's been turned. No, he's not being turned. Perhaps a big effort was made by Jeremy Metcalf to try and take the lead, which didn't work for him, because Paddy Shuffling clipping the curve there as he comes into his lots and maintains his advantage, if not opened it up slightly from what it was when he went past you. And then behind, and we've got another place there, not another place again. It nearly was over by James Gordon on the car then, and there's Philip Burns doing what he can to keep number two. Hector Lester. So the two leading Ferraris then coming through, headed still by Paddy Shuffling from number 16, Jeremy Metcalf. And Phil Burton has certainly learned an awful lot about how to keep quick drivers behind it. And he's going to go mid-side, and he's turned it up. Oh, that was close.
Four, I think, Peter Bamford to give way to Matt Griffin. Number 20, Craig Wilkins, Brown Scott, 42, Tom Alexander for Michael Bench, with a pit